press release of World Spiritual Assembly New York, USA press release dated November 8, 2020. Press release titled, "The World's Greatest Hypocrite and Dangerous Person Mr. Henry Kissinger is the Godfather of the World Jewish Zionist Community and Other Dangerous Hypocrites for the Mankind and Peace. They all will be punished by the arrival of Crown Prince of Peace. Imam Mahdi and Reemergence of Jesus Christ, PBUH. After the First World War, he migrated from Germany to USA with his family. Him along with his family members are leading the American economy, politics and also playing the major role in illegally occupying Palestinian lands and properties in West Bank. And him along with his Jewish Zionist gangsters have developed the so-called State of Israel, by the active cooperation of British government currently American government also by another greatest hypocrite former U.S. President Donald Trump along with Trump's son-in-law Jared Kushner. Above mentioned dangerous individuals will be punished soon, their camouflaging game has been over." Picture of World's Greatest Hypocrite and Danger for Mankind Mr. Henry Kissinger. Biography. Heinz Alfred Kissinger was born in Bavaria, Germany in 1923 to a German Jewish family. His father's name Louis Kissinger, 1887 to 1982, was a school teacher. His mother's name Paula Stern Kissinger, 1901 to 1998, was a homemaker. His brother, Walter Kissinger, was born in 1924. In 1938, when Kissinger was 15 years old, he and his family fled Germany as a result of Nazi persecution. The family briefly immigrated to London before arriving in New York City on September 5. After Kissinger family immigrated to USA, Kissinger spent his high school years in the Washington Heights section of Upper Manhattan as part of the German Jewish immigrant community. Kissinger was always very clever and cunning from young age, hence he assimilated quickly into American culture. He never lost his pronounced German accent, although while he was growing he perceived to be shy but he was very much an observant character, that made him hesitant to speak. After his first year at George Washington High School, he began attending school at night and worked in a shaving brush factory during the day. While he was growing up, he quickly learned that America was a land of opportunity and people were very naive unlike what he saw in Germany. He had an urge to be a leader that can avenge the actions that he and his family experienced back in Germany. Kissinger enrolled in the City College of New York, studying accounting. He excelled academically as a part-time student, continuing to work while enrolled. While opportunity came in disguise, his studies were interrupted in early 1943, when he was drafted into the U.S. Army. But somehow he made to attend basic training at Camp Croft in Spartanburg, South Carolina. On June 19, 1943, while stationed in South Carolina, at the age of 20 years, he became a naturalized U.S. citizen. The Army sent him to study engineering at Lafayette College, Pennsylvania, but the program was canceled, and Kissinger was reassigned to the 84th Infantry Division. It may be mentioned here that Kissinger was never interested in involving himself in practical hand-to-hand combat. Somehow with his cunning character he made the acquaintance of Fritz Kramer, a fellow immigrant from Germany who noted Kissinger's fluency in German and his intellect, and arranged for him to be assigned to the military intelligence section of the division. Kissinger saw opportunity in volunteering for intelligence duties during the Battle of the Bulge. During the American advance into Germany, Kissinger, only a private, was put in charge of the administration of the city of Krefeld, owing to a lack of German speakers on the division's intelligence staff. Within 8 days he had established a civilian administration. Kissinger was then reassigned to the Counterintelligence Corps, with the rank of sergeant. He was given charge of a team in Hanover assigned to tracking down Gestapo officers and other saboteurs, for which he was awarded the Bronze Star. In June 1945, Kissinger was made commandant of the Bensheim Metro CIC detachment, Bergstrasse district of Hesse, with responsibility for denazification of the district. Although he possessed absolute authority and powers of arrest, Kissinger took care to avoid abuses against the local Jewish population by his command. In 1946, Kissinger was reassigned to teach at the European Command Intelligence School at Camp King, continuing to serve in this role as a civilian employee following his separation from the army. By the age of 23 to 24 Kissinger was already in the attention of the elite leaders in UK and USA like the Rothschild and Rockefeller's family, through which he managed to graduate in summa cum laude from Harvard College in 1950 and received MA and PhD degrees from Harvard University in 1952 and 1954. He was slowly getting groomed to be at the forefront of the US politics. He was a member of the faculty of Harvard University from 1954 to 1969. In both the Department of Government and the Center for International Affairs. He also served as director of the Harvard International Seminar from 1952 to 1969. In 1952, While still at Harvard, he served as a consultant to the director of the Psychological Strategy Board. His doctoral dissertation was titled Peace, Legitimacy, and the Equilibrium, a study of the statesmanship of Castlereagh and Metternich. Kissinger remained at Harvard as a member of the faculty in the Department of Government and at the Center for International Affairs. He became associate director of the latter in 1957. In 1955, he was a consultant to the National Security Council's Operations Coordinating Board. During 1955 and 1956, he was also study director in nuclear weapons and foreign policy at the Council on Foreign Relations. He released his book Nuclear Weapons and Foreign Policy the following year. From 1956 to 1958, he worked for the Rockefeller Brothers Fund as director of its Special Studies Project. He was director of the Harvard Defense Studies Program between 1958 and 1971. He was also director of the Harvard International Seminar between 1951 and 1971. Outside of academia, he served as a consultant to several government agencies, including the Operations Research Office, the Arms Control and Disarmament Agency, and the Department of State, and the RAND Corporation, a think tank. On September 22, 1973, Henry Alfred Kissinger was sworn in as the 56th Secretary of State. He held the position till January 20, 1977. He also served as Assistant to the President for National Security Affairs from January 20, 1969, until November 3, 1975. In July 1983, he was appointed by President Reagan to chair the National Bipartisan Commission on Central America until it ceased operation in January 1985, and from 1984 to 1990 he served as a member of the President's Foreign Intelligence Advisory Board. From 1986 to 1988 he was a member of the Commission on Integrated Long-Term Strategy of the National Security Council and Defense Department. He served as a member of the Defense Policy Board from 2001 to 2016. At present, Dr. Kissinger is chairman of Kissinger Associates Incorporated, an international consulting firm. He is also a member of the International Council of J.P. Morgan Chase & Company, a counselor to and trustee of the Center for Strategic and International Studies, an honorary governor of the Foreign Policy Association, and an honor member of the International Olympic Committee. Among his other activities, Dr. Kissinger served as a member of the board of directors of Conti Group Companies Incorporated from 1988 to 2014 and remains an advisor to the board, a position he also holds at American Express Company since 2005, after serving on the board from 1984. He is also a trustee emeritus of the Metropolitan Museum of Art, a director emeritus of Freeport MCMO Rand Copper and Gold Incorporated, and a director of the International Rescue Committee. Kissinger successfully covered up his immoral activities against mankind through the awards he has received, such as Bronze Star from the U.S. Army in 1945, the Nobel Peace Prize in 1973, the Presidential Medal of Freedom, the nation's highest civilian award, in 1977, and the Medal of Liberty, given one time to 10 foreign-born American leaders, in 1986. Kissinger's role in wars around the world. Kissinger's involvement in Indochina war started prior to his appointment as National Security Advisor to Nixon. While still at Harvard, he had worked as a consultant on foreign policy to both the White House and State Department. Kissinger played a key role in bombing Cambodia to disrupt Pathan Viet Cong units launching raids into South Vietnam from within Cambodia's borders and resupplying their forces by using the Ho Chi Minh Trail and other routes, as well as the 1970 Cambodian incursion and subsequent widespread bombing of Khmer Rouge targets in Cambodia. In February 1970, several senators led by J. William Fulbright and Stu Symington first learned that the United States had been bombing Laos since December 1964, which led to complaints in Congress about the secret war in Laos. When Kissinger was summoned to a meeting at the White House about Cambodia, he joked, "Our peerless leader has flipped out." On May 2, 1970, U.S. aircraft bombed North Vietnam for the first time since 1968. Causing Senator Fulbright to say good God when he heard the news, while Senate Majority Leader, Mike Mansfield, said he had trouble believing that Nixon and Kissinger were so reckless. Kissinger worked tirelessly during the Vietnam War to expand the foothold of American imperial agenda throughout Asian continent at the cost of 60,000-plus U.S. soldiers. During the 1971 liberation movement of East Pakistan, Kissinger and Nixon supported West Pakistan by providing intelligence to arms and ammunition. Kissinger's ultimate agenda was to exert pressure on India for its close ties to communist Soviet Union. East Pakistan ultimately gained independence through the sacrifice of 300,000 innocent civilians and became Bangladesh. But Kissinger's anger of not being able to achieve his agenda led Bangladesh to suffer even more, Kissinger played a huge role at U.S. Senate and United Nations against the newly formed Bangladesh's recognition. He also made sure Bangladesh doesn't get enough humanitarian aids, which led to the Great Famine and loss of several thousand innocent lives in Bangladesh in 1974. He labeled Bangladesh as bottomless basket whilst his visit to Dhaka. Fortunately, the young senator from Delaware at the time, current President Joe Biden, along with Senator late Ted Kennedy, strongly fought to support the Bangladesh's recognition. Kissinger's role in biological warfare and creation of AIDS virus. According to an article published by Dr. Ernest Shapiro, Horowitz documents Kissinger's preference for covert operations, as shown, for example, in his February 1976 testimony before the Senate Subcommittee on African Affairs of the Senate Foreign Relations Committee. The Angola situation, Kissinger intoned, is of a type where diplomacy without leverage is impotent, yet direct military confrontation would involve unnecessary risks. Thus, it is precisely one of those gray areas where covert methods are crucial if we are to have any prospect of influencing certain events of potentially global importance. Horowitz presents evidence that such possible operations may very well have included biological warfare. Horowitz delves at some length into Kissinger's oligarchical political philosophy, in which policy disagreements are settled by force, and there is no place for morality, only self-interest. In 1969, he ordered a survey of chemical and biological weapons. He and Nixon signed a treaty to eliminate these weapons, but they secretly kept a supply. Horowitz believes that Kissinger ordered the Defense Department to request an appropriation from Congress for an AIDS-like virus to be produced. Kissinger's policy, including the malfusion policy of NSSM 200, was continued by the Carter administration, under the direction of Joseph Califano, the Secretary of Health, Education, and Welfare. Califano had previously held high positions in the Defense Department, including that of Deputy Secretary of Defense. Another important figure was Dr. Donald Francis, who currently heads the hepatitis branch of the Centers for Disease Control, CDC. He had a background that included research into cat leukemia, hepatitis B, and epidemiological studies on infectious diseases. When the Ebola virus struck in Zaire in 1976, he was a medical officer on the scene, on loan to the World Health Organization from CDC. Kissinger, a war criminal. Two American generations have experienced Kissinger's treachery firsthand, but most certainly his mastermind blueprints of controlling world order are still in play. He is most certainly a war criminal. According to Molly Ivan's article on Buffalo News, he is wanted for questioning in Chile, Argentina and France, concerning French citizens who disappeared in Chile. He cannot travel to Britain, Brazil and many other countries because they cannot guarantee his immunity from legal proceedings. In addition to his role in the 1973 Chilean coup that brought General Augusto Pinochet to power, Kissinger also is wanted for questioning about the international terrorist network called Operation Condor, which conducted killings, kidnappings and bombings in several countries, including this one, the 1976 bombing in Washington, D.C., that killed a noted Chilean dissident and his companion. Kissinger's most notorious act was the secret bombing of Cambodia and Laos during the Vietnam War. William Shaw Cross argued persuasively in his book Sideshow, Kissinger, Nixon and the Destruction of Cambodia, that the Cambodian bombing unleashed the Khmer Rouge on that country, which, if true, certainly ups Kissinger's body count. Kissinger's role in September 11th terror attack. He is also a notorious liar. He has lied repeatedly to Congress, the press and the public. He is a toady to power and a lackey of the establishment, and for many years now the hireling of despotic regimes around the world. Old cover-up Kissinger, the man who double-crossed the Iraqi Kurds, just the man to lead an independent inquiry into 9/11. Kissinger insists he need not reveal the identities of his client regimes. He said law firms are not required to reveal the names of their clients. That's a two-lie answer, no record for Henry the K. He doesn't run a law firm, he runs an international consulting business. And in the second place, law firms are indeed obliged to publicly register their lobbying clients. Kissinger's role in coronavirus. While the world experiences extreme change, the notorious Kissinger publishes an article stating how the world will never be the same. The world order certainly will change. There may not be anything yet that surfaced in mainstream, which can tie the links to Kissinger for current ongoing disaster known as coronavirus. But we can assume that he was the mastermind that started the research work on the biological warfare. He is also the mastermind in covering up all of the covert operations around world, be it biological warfare or terrorist attack like September 11th. It would be logical to conclude somewhere, somehow or someway he had something to do with this virus being widespread. According to Japanese Nobel laureate Professor Tasuku Honjo has declared that, This COVID-19 has multiple strains, even though at first he claimed the virus to be man-made, later he stated that it can have a natural strain. Also, according to Luc Montagnier, who won the Nobel Prize in 2008 for his work on HIV, stated that biologists have having created SARS-CoV-2, the virus that causes COVID-19, in a lab. World influential leaders are requested to pay attention by the leadership of U.S. President Joe Biden to take appropriate action plan to save the mankind from mysterious man-made disease COVID-19 virus. He may call upon Luc Montagnier and Tasu Kuhonjo and other resourceful scientists to work together to eliminate this virus for greater good of humanity as per his election commitment. Kissinger's protege Jared Kushner. Picture of Jared Kushner, son-in-law of Donald Trump and protege of Henry Kissinger. It may be mentioned here that Henry Kissinger has been a lifetime member of secret organizations such as Bilderberg Group. Bilderberg Group is a secret organization that has members across the world consisting of influential world leaders, wealthy businessmen, or anyone that can or has the ability to control the masses for the greater good of organizations like Bilderberg Group. Recently, Jared Kushner, the son-in-law of most hated criminal of 20th century Donald Trump, was seen together at a Bilderberg meeting in Switzerland. It can be understood that Kissinger had been grooming Kushner for similar roles that he had played for the past 6 to 7 decades. Following are the world's worst criminals, murderers, and danger for the mankind and Muslim world. Picture of, from left, most dangerous criminals and danger for mankind and Muslims around the world: immoral, gambler and womanizer Donald Trump, former president of USA, hypocrite criminal Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu of Israel, and President Emmanuel Macron of France. Picture of, so-called immoral Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman of Saudi Arabia, Crown Prince Mohammed bin Zayed of UAE, and President Mohammed Sisi of Egypt. Picture of, from left, Xi Jinping, danger for the Uyghur Muslims of China and mankind, along with Aung San Suu Kyi, as danger for the Rohingya Muslims in Myanmar. Picture of, from left, Narendra Modi and Amit Shah are danger for mankind and the Muslims in India as well as South Asia. Middle, late Pranab Mukherjee were the mastermind in creating plots to control and destroy the backbone of Bangladesh and danger for the Muslims in Bangladesh. Sheikh Mujib contributed to the cause of Pranab in various ways to destroy the backbone of Bangladesh. Currently, Sheikh Mujib's immoral daughter, from right, Sheikh Hasina, are following the blueprint of Pranab Mukherjee to destroy full democratic system, economy, as well as brought total loss of rule of law and justice in Bangladesh. Following are the brave strong leaders of Muslim world. Picture of, Recep Tayyip Erdogan, President of Turkey and President of OIC, Organization of Islamic Cooperation, is designated by WSA to destroy the dangerous criminals of Muslim world like so-called immoral Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman of Saudi Arabia and Mohammed bin Zayed of UAE. Recently, he has declared to start a crusade against the France and its immoral President Emmanuel Macron for disrespecting the Holy Prophet in the name of freedom of speech. He is empowered by the presidential authority of OIC to take over the Hijaz, Mecca and Medina, from the corrupted rule of Saudi Kingdom. He is also designated to liberate the Muslims of Yemen, Kashmir, Rohingyas of Myanmar and Uyghur of China. He will also liberate Holy Jerusalem from the illegal occupation by the State of Israel, which was self-proclaimed as illegal capital of the State of Israel by the active cooperation of former U.S. President Donald Trump. Picture of, retired Major Delwar Hossein of Bangladesh Army is designated by WHRSC as Commander-in-Chief to curb down the fascist leader Sheikh Hasina and her gangsters of Bangladesh to establish rule of law and justice in Bangladesh. The above-mentioned information about most dangerous person of the world Henry Kissinger and other dangerous leaders for the mankind are all collected from various authentic sources, which are as follows. Reference 1. Biography from Encyclopedia and Britannica. Reference 2. Kissinger's Return is Mind-Boggling by Molly Ivins, published on December 11, 2002 by the Buffalo News. Reference 3. Article on Secret Societies, Freemasons, Knights Templar on History.com. Reference 4. Article title, Henry Kissinger Memoirs, Agony of the Bangladesh War on February 19, 2014, published on India Times. Reference 5. Origins of the AIDS Virus, Accident or Biowarfare? By Dr. Ernest Shapiro. Reference 6. Article titled, Disputed French Nobel Winner Luc Montagnier Says COVID-19 Was Made in a Lab Laboratory on ConnectionFrance.com. Finally, I express my deep appreciation at forwarding this valuable information to the world concerned dignitaries, intellectuals, scientists, world leaders, kings, emperors of the world, as United States of America's 46th President-elect Joe Biden and Vice President-elect Kamala Harris to carefully observe and curb down hypocrites, greatest danger of mankind as Commander-in-Chief and Leader of the World as your election commitment of 2020. This message is the clarion call for the mankind and their future of the third civilization. The Millennium Prophecy heralds a golden age proclaimed by His Eminency Dr. Hazrat Sheikh Shah Sufi MN Alam to the heads of state and world leaders. To the honorable heads of state, heads of government, kings, emperors, distinguished religious leaders, intellectuals and scientists, I am disclosing valuable information concerning the future. It is the age of science and the era of utmost improvement in human civilization. It is known from history that this is the second human civilization on earth. At the time of the Prophet Noah, PBUH, the culture, developed science and education of the first civilization vanished away from the earth by flood and earthquake. It is also known that 4,000 years ago the Atlantic Ocean was once the shape of a continent with different nations, where many cultures lived. According to historical findings, under the Atlantic Ocean there is a lost city called the Atlantis, as a continent, collapsed in consequence of universal cataclysm and earthquakes resulting into an ocean. Therefore, we see how tremendous the history of mankind is. Archaeologists and scientists are discovering innumerable relics of human civilization and history through digging and searching the soil. Many aspects of our current civilization is likely to be wiped away completely from the earth after the year 2020 AD. Human beings will build up the third civilization as indicated in the sacred Holy Alcoran, the Torah, and the Zabur, the Bible, Injil, the Kalki Puran, Hindu sacred text, and others. The present civilization will end after the global year 2020, after the occurrence of a third world war if man does not heed his inner voice. This inner spiritual urging is given expression by the modern prophet His Eminency Dr. Hazrat Sheikh Shah Sufi MN Alam. A new civilization will begin by the permanent peace messenger of Almighty God, the great Imam Mahdi, PBUH, who will come from a region in the Arabian desert. As desired by God, Jesus Christ, Nabi Isha, PBUH, is to establish a world government based in Jerusalem, creating heaven on earth after the year 2020. This statement refers to the great transformation, which will occur at the time of the new millennium. Similar prophecies concerning this period are the subject of most of the world's religions, as well as of astrologers and modern Western prophets like Nostradamus, Edgar Cayce, and Gene Dixon. This statement is made here as an appeal to the heads of state, as well as to the people of the planet, to make every effort to bring peace to the planet and to prepare ourselves spiritually for the great events, which are about to occur in our lifetime. According to the Holy Quran and the leaders of the Sufi orders, the course of human history and the present conditions are leading to the Third World War and the destruction of the planet. This will result in the dawning of an entirely different system of human values and organizations. According to Sufi cosmology, civilization began with Adam, PBUH, the first man. Biblical floods and earthquakes destroyed this civilization at the time of the prophet Noah, PBUH, about 4,000 years ago. This gave rise to the second and present civilization, which may come to an end unless humanity heeds its inner voice, given expression by the modern prophet His Eminency Dr. Hazrat Sheikh Shah Sufi MN Alam. The present civilization, which is based on military might, economic exploitation and the dependence of the industrialized world on cheap crude oil, will pave the way for the Third World War. Other factors contributing to the war are the fragmentation of the Soviet Union and the resultant economic chaos there, and the impoverishment of Africa and Asia. The economic pressure that a unified Europe will place on the United States and the competition for diminishing natural resources will also create pressure. Incomparable and beyond imagination, the Third World War will cause famine and drought worldwide. The nations of the West will face economic crisis and political instability. There will be no rest in the landscapes or cities like New York, San Francisco, Chicago, including other 30 states of USA, Tokyo, Beijing, Rome, Addis Ababa, Johannesburg, Sana, Mount Himalaya of Nepal, New Delhi, Calcutta, Bombay, Assam, Tripura of India, Bangkok of Thailand, Dhaka, Khulna, Chittagong, Sylhet of Bangladesh, Tel Aviv of Israel, Jakarta, East Timor of Indonesia, some territories of Russia, Cairo of Egypt, Riyadh, Jeddah of Saudi Arabia and some areas of Afghanistan, also many other cities, lands, mountains of the world. Natural disasters caused by man-made behavior will also add to the destruction. The prophecy holds that three-quarters of all living beings and natural resources will be destroyed by this probable war. His Eminency Dr. MN Alam's proclamation is that, in the course of the war, the descendants of Abraham, the Jews, Christians and Muslims, will fight with each other, but none shall dominate. The earth will be laid to waste in their struggle. A point to be noted, His Eminency Dr. M.N. Alam is not an enemy of any religion, not even having any personal grounds to publish such real fact, but for the spread of the real truth, which is the human being is the crown creation of Almighty God. And Abraham's descendants, the Jews, Christians, and Muslims, are cousin brothers in accordance to the Holy Quran. The war will come to an end after the destruction of the oil supply and technological infrastructure. At this time, when humanity is facing extinction, a self-proclaimed king and god named King Dajjal will appear in the area of the Red Sea. He will declare himself the custodian of heaven and make war on all who do not accept him as their god. While this situation is occurring, after 2020 a spiritual being called the Great Imam Mahdi, PBUH, an inhabitant of the Arabian Desert, and a descendant of the Prophet Muhammad, PBUH, will be proclaimed as universal leader in the holy city Mecca, Saudi Arabia. This will occur after the year 2020. On the same year, Jesus Christ, Nabi Isa, PBUH, is expecting to appear from the blue sky in the city of Damascus, capital of Syria, in the minaret of Holy Umayyad Mosque. Jesus Christ, Nabi Isa, PBUH, will expel King Dajjal. With the co-leadership of Great Imam Mahdi, PBUH, and Jesus Christ, Nabi Isa, PBUH, heaven on earth will be created for all beings. The people of the earth will be unified into one nation, having one government, and worshipping one God. The Great Imam Mahdi, PBUH, will establish this new world order in Jerusalem, the unified center of world harmony and peace. Imam Mahdi, PBUH, will then lead humanity into the Golden Age, unifying heaven and earth. There will no longer be any destructive intent, or any need for weapons of mass destruction. After the year 2032, Jesus Christ, Nabi Isa, PBUH, will lead the new world government approximately until or after December 2052. The people of the earth will be unified in a confederation of governments. All will accept the Great Imam Mahdi, PBUH, as the universal leader. The mindless power struggle will vanish under his spiritual leadership. This period of peace and joy will last until a little after 2052. After the year 2052, another world leader named King Jaja will come to power to continue the spiritual legacy. He will lead until 2102. At this time, a leader from Africa will emerge, and thereafter descendants of his dynasty will lead for the next 900 years. During this time, confusion and chaos will again come about. Eventually, the Holy Mosque at Holy Mecca will be destroyed and the spiritual strength of pure Islam will gradually decline, and 7,000 years of human civilization may come to an end on the planet Earth. Humanity can have an alternative future, however, if it heeds in time the Holy Voice. The Prince of Peace, the merciful source of life, the one living God in His infinite love, speaks to mankind through the voice of the prophets. If humanity heeds the warnings of its inner voice, given expression by the modern prophets, to cease its inhuman behavior, to care for the environment, to respect all life as an expression of divine intention, only then humanity will sustain spiritual grace and dwell in the house of the Lord forevermore. This too can be our destiny. This gigantic task of research on the Millennium Prophecy Statement from the Holy Alquran, Old Testament of the Bible, religious research books and opinion of the concerned intellectuals, is also based on astrology, astronomy, geography and philosophy. Included are also the interfaith opinions of the religious personalities of the world from the major religious groups. Natural disasters in North America and Europe, as well as many man-made disasters, prefigure many of the realizations of the prophecy. Former UN Secretary General Dr. Kofi Annan has advised the Millennium Prophecy should be forwarded to the US mission in NY and taken into the General Assembly and Security Council agenda. Statements of the Union of Concerned Scientists point to the validity of Millennium Prophecy. Prominent world scientists have warned humanity that we must take certain actions on behalf of our planet, if widespread human misery is to be avoided in the new millennium. These 1,600 senior scientists, including 102 Nobel laureates, target resource management, population control, poverty, sexual equality and maintaining ecological balance of Earth's systems as the five critical areas requiring attention. They tell us that a new attitude of gratitude and responsibility is required by us, if we are to create a harmonious balance between humanity and our environment. The Union of Concerned Scientists is headquartered in Cambridge, Massachusetts, USA. Background history of Sufi prophecy, heritage and record. On the Arabian Peninsula in the 6th century, the Prophet Muhammad, PBUH, preached the religion of humanity to establish permanent peace on the surface of the planet Earth. After re-entering the holy city of Mecca with the Prophet's new vision for mankind, the Prophet predicted Sufi prophecy in presence of 100,000 of his followers. According to Sufi cosmology, it has been predicted that a child would be born in the Arabian desert around or after the year 1962. The prediction cited that the child would be born, resembling Prophet Muhammad, in a farmer's house, and will be born within the Prophet's family, and his father's name would be Abdullah and his mother's name Amina. The Prophet also indicated that there would be two occurrences after the year 2020, the miraculous reappearance of Jesus Christ, PBUH, and the enlightening arrival of the new Messenger of God, Imam Mahdi, PBUH. The child would lead humanity together with Jesus Christ, PBUH, to co-create heaven on earth. This Sufi legacy has been predicted innumerable times before, first by the great Ali, PBUH, of the 7th century, 4th Khalifa of Islam at Kufa, Iraq, during the 9th century by the great Sufi Saint Abdul Qadir Jilani, PBUH. In the 11th century, the Sufi master Sheikh Ni'amatullah, PBUH, of Kashmir, India, predicted the details of the prophecy in his 54 Persian poems. Sheikh Mujahid al-Faisani, PBUH, another Sufi master at Shirhind, West Punjab, India, was detained by Mughal Emperor Akbar in the 16th century for his similar predictions. The 43rd spiritual successor from the Prophet of Islam, Chief Khalifa and custodian of Deir-e Sharif, of the 700-years-old Sufi dynasty and president of the World Spiritual Assembly, His Eminency Dr. Hazrat Sheikh Shah Sufi MN Alam, confirmed this prediction as being true in the Earth Summit and Global Forum in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil, in June 3, 1992. Through his 25 years research of mathematics, astronomy, astrology, theology, science, Sufi cosmology and the exploration of 186 countries, the prophecy has been rationalized and affirmed by the presentation of the ex-executive director, Seshadri Gupta of India. This prophecy was proclaimed in the Earth Summit and Global Forum at Rio de Janeiro, Brazil, in June 3, 1992, for the sole reason of safeguarding human society. It was recorded on radio, television and with other competent authorities. Originally brought forth in the early 1980s, just as the nuclear arms race gathered geometric momentum, and as man's strident hostility grew ever louder and less rational, the prophecy pointed to the extreme, yet very real, possibility of man's annihilation. Initially, much abuse was heaped on the well-meaning seer who is the 43rd direct spiritual successor of the Prophet of Islam. Derision greeted his extremist views, first expressed to a wide audience at the Global Environment Summit at Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. He has also expressed his views in over 700 other conferences, symposiums and in many noted international organizations and meetings held at the five continents of the world. It is not easy to wake a sleeping giant to a wider reality, particularly if he is asleep, to the fact that he is trapped in a naive and hostile illusion. And it follows that when it is necessary to awaken, the sound of the alarm is always perhaps somewhat jarring to a sleeping man. It may be mentioned here that the Prophet Noah PBUH warned his followers, sons and wife till the last moment before the biblical flood of Mount Sana of Yemen, but they refused to attend to his words even then. Dr. T.H. Rampa, a Tibetan with supernatural powers, has written a profound thesis on the Tibetan's religion mythological data entitled Chapter of Life, in which he mentions that near or after the year 2020 a world religious leader will be heralded. With his arrival, the world state will change entirely and enter into a new era of development through his leadership. People will be able to communicate from far distances not only among each other, but also with animals. They will also be able to foresee the future with help of supernatural powers. A revolution in religious rejuvenation in man and woman will also occur. Dr. T.H. Rampa further stated on page 138 of his thesis, that on February 5, 1962 the Milky Way's celestial bodies will fall into a 16th position. Eventually, on or after May 5, 2020 these same bodies, Sun, Moon, Jupiter, Venus, Mars, Mercury and Saturn, will fall into the same position. This phenomenon will bring about a great change in civilization, as we know it. He also states that after the 5th day of May 2020 AD, the history of mankind will enter a new age where peace will reign. The pioneer spokesman of the authentic prophecies before 800 years ago. Hazrat Shah Sufi Ni'amatullah, R.A. The historical prophecies in verse of Hazrat Shah Ni'amatullah about the imminent Third World War, World War III, and the coming of the Imam Mahdi, peace be upon him. A brief account of the life and prophecies of Hazrat Shah Ni'amatullah. Hazrat Shah Ni'amatullah was born during the rule of the Sultan Raja Khan Turkmen. His father was the Venerable Mir Sayyid Atullah, and he was born in the city of Nurul in Kashmir. This is why he is renowned everywhere as Saint of Kashmir and Shah-e-Hamdan. Although originally he was Persian from Isfahan, currently Iran. By the grace of God the Almighty, Hazrat Shah Niamatullah began to speak fluently even before he was weaned from his mother's breast. His respected father, who loved learning, left this world when he was just a child. His father was a notable personage in Sultan Raju Khan's court, and upon hearing about his death, the Sultan's wife Yatim took on the responsibility of bringing him up and educating him. She arranged to have him tutored together with her sons. Only at the age of 13, Hazrat Shah Niamatullah became well versed in the spiritual instructions as well as in archery, swordsmanship and other aspects of warfare. But he was always disinterested in everyday life. He received his first spiritual orders from the contemporary Hazrat Sheikh Mohammed. To gain further knowledge, he became a disciple of the very learned Hazrat Hakim Jibrail Daulat Abadi, who, impressed with his student's powers, had his daughter married to him. Hazrat Shah Niamatullah then went to Ferozepur and received his spiritual powers from his spiritual teacher. Spending 16 years in hardship there, people began to hear of his many extraordinary and fabulous words there. At particular times he would make certain pronouncements which could have only come from someone blessed with the Almighty God's spiritual and special powers. For this reason, he came to be known as Shah-e-Hamdan of Kashmir. His most notable composition is a translation of the Holy Quran in Farsi. The number of words in the translation equals exactly the number present in the original Holy Quran. Of his many predictions composed in prose and verse, none of the prose versions are extant today, and only some of the prophecies in verse have survived. The predictions he made over 800 years ago, in his 56 poems in Farsi, have been proven to be true from the rule of Timurilan, the First and the Second World Wars and other world historical events. Additionally, His Eminency Dr. Shah Sheikh Sufi Aman Alam has based much of the work in his Millennium Prophecy on the predictions made by Hazrat Sheikh Niamatullah in his Farsi poems. The Red Heifer or the Perfect Red Cow. According to the Temple Institute, a Jewish organization's end times prophecy, they are awaiting a birth of the Red Heifer or the Perfect Red Cow. For it, they claim it's the sign to start the construction of the Third Temple at the Temple Mount area where the Rock of the Dome is located. This rock is located near Masjid al-Aqsa in the Holy Land of Jerusalem. By the grace of Allah, the Almighty, the rock had been floating for 4,000 years until its descent. The Prophet Muhammad, PBUH, had performed the journey to heaven, Mi'raj, from this rock, as it accompanied him until he reached space. In 1988, His Eminency Dr. Hazrat Sheikh Shah Sufi Aman Alam saw the rock with his own eyes when he went to visit the Al-Aqsa Mosque as a representative of the United Nations. The Israeli government under the Zionist hypocrite Jews rule had been waiting for their so-called promised Messiah, the Antichrist or Dajjal. The current U.S. President Donald J. Trump also had been working very hard with those Zionist hypocrite Jews and misusing the single superpower United States authority. His illegal declaration of the holy city Jerusalem in 2018 as the capital of Israel has triggered tremendous bloodshed against the innocent Palestinians by the active cooperation of Israeli IDF forces. In August 2019, the Temple Institute has announced again such news and press release, that the 2,000 years of prophecy is being fulfilled by the birth of the Red Heifer or the Perfect Red Cow. Accordingly, on November 19, 2019, the Trump administration declared the illegal settlements in West Bank are not illegal according to international court. Hence, the Israeli IDF forces continued their bloodshed on the innocent Palestinians. Recently they killed over 800 innocent children amongst thousands more casualties. According to Surah Baqarah of Holy Quran and the Old Testament of Torah and Bible, there is no mention of such red heifer or perfect red cow to claim the arrival of so-called Messiah. The hypocrite Zionist Jews is exercising their malpractice knowledge to deceive innocent Jews and Christians to believe their so-called false Messiah, the Antichrist or Dajjal, will arrive to save them. Imam Mahdi, PBUH, and Jesus Christ, PBUH, are the final Messiah of Jewish, Christians, and Muslims. His Eminency Dr. Hazrat Sheikh Shah Sufi Aman Alam, alarming the citizens of the world, the arrival of Imam Mahdi with Reemergence of Jesus Christ is just days away, along with the Third World War is knocking the door. Soon, the false Messiah, the Antichrist or Dajjal, as well as Donald J. Trump along with his associates like Benjamin Netanyahu, Putin, Xi Jinping and Narendra Modi will be wiped away by the arrival of Imam Mahdi and Jesus Christ. Prophet Muhammad SM's Proclamation of Ghazwa-e-Hind. 1,400 years ago, great prophet of mankind, Hazrat Muhammad SM's prophecy of Ghazwa-e-Hind was stated in front of many of his prominent Sahabas and Munafiqs. Such the following is mentioned by Hazrat Shub in two groups amongst my Ummah would be whom Allah has freed from fire. One group would fight against India and the second would be that who would accompany Imam Mahdi and Isa ibn Maryam PBUH. Also Imam Nesai reported on al-Sunan al-Mujtaba and al-Sunan al-Kubra that Munafiq Abu Huraira, whom narrated 6,000 false hadiths, had said, "Hazrat Muhammad, PBUH, promised us of God's Wahi Hind. If I get a chance to participate in it, I would spend all my energy and wealth for it. If I get killed, I would be considered among the greatest martyrs. And if I come back alive, then I would be a freed." This statement is fabricated by Munafiq Abu Huraira, but as a matter of fact, Prophet Muhammad SM did prophesy about the Ghazwa-e Hind. Coincidentally, after the British rule ended over South Asian subcontinent, it gave birth to Pakistan and India with unsettled geographical territories such as Kashmir. According to a famous Sufi saint of Kashmir, Shaniyamatrilara, the war between Indian and Pakistan shall start between from Eid al-Adha and Eid al-Fitr, but he did not mention which particular year. Consequently, the current Prime Minister of India, Narendra Modi, whom is declared follower of Hitler's RSS group, has revoked Article 370 and 35A, which nullifies Kashmir as the independent territory. Narendra Modi, along with his partner Benjamin Netanyahu, who is actively working to kill innocent Muslims in Kashmir and all over India, as humble Jewish agent. The recent biased judgment on Babri Masjid is also another evidence that Narendra Modi actively working against the Muslims of India. Single superpower USA, along with Russia, China and India, are working actively against the Myanmar's Rohingya peoples, since they live on very rich and resourceful land on the coast of Bay of Bengal in Myanmar. After the British rule, the above-mentioned superpowers had constantly waged genocide against the Rohingyas. The current communist Chinese government is trying to act as a superpower in the Asian region with the direct assistance from Russia to expel the local population of Uyghur Muslims from Xinjiang region of China. Xinjiang is filled with heavy minerals such as iron, copper, uranium and other minerals. China, along with Russia, is committing a gross violation of human rights in Xinjiang region and other areas against the Uyghur Muslims. It has been reported in several news media outlets that China had been secretly forming concentration camps since 2014 to force the Uyghur Muslims into China's communist ideology. Xi Jinping's communist Chinese government had killed several thousands of Uyghur Muslims and also profiting huge amount of money by selling their body organs to Israel and European countries. His Eminency is alarming the final warning against the communist Chinese government to stop their genocide against the Uyghur Muslims, else they will face the ultimate punishment by the arrival of Imam and Jesus Christ, PBUH. His Eminency Dr. Hazrat Sheikh Shah Sufi Emin Alam has declared that Narendra Modi, Benjamin Netanyahu and Xi Jinping, along with their godfathers, will be wiped clean by Prophet Muhammad SM's proclamation of Ghazwa-e Hind, as well as with the arrival of Imam Mahdi and re-emergence of Jesus Christ, Kashmir along with India, Palestine and Rohingyas of Myanmar, also Uyghur Muslims of China, will be free from all oppression and tyrant rulers. The vision of the Millennium Prophecy of His Eminency Dr. Hazrat Sheikh Shah Sufi Muhammad Nurul Alam can now be recognized as a clarion call to man to awaken from his dream of the naive voice of antagonism. This enlightened seer can be heard as the voice of mankind's call to reason. This humble and gifted spiritual personality from Asia, having spent his lifetime studying the wide sweep of forces, both within and without, that seemed to propel man along the path toward his destiny, recognized that it would take a shock, an extreme event, to alter man's course. If we continue the way we are going, says the spiritual being and seer His Eminency Dr. Hazrat Sheikh Shah Sufi Emin Alam, we will end up where we are headed, and that, he points out, is in mutual destruction, the end of our contemporary civilization. The Prophet's fundamental message is a simple one, that we must awaken our gratitude for the extraordinary privilege that it is to be heir to the possibility of what being human is. And that out of the awareness, our gratitude must lead us to take responsibility for a harmonious balance between man and environment, between man and man. He suggests to us that only if we step beyond our naive antagonism can we avert the consequences of the course we are on. Specifically, we must recognize our unity and lay aside hostility between national boundaries and religious schism. We must manage our populations, our ecology and our resources while we bring about equality and eliminate poverty. Great Prophet of Mankind Hazrat Muhammad, PBUH, prophesied about the fanaticism in Islam along with the invention of various sectarian movements. Prophet also stated that all of the sects of Islam will eventually proceed to hellfire except one that will lead him and his descendants, albeit, with the proper guideline of Holy Quran. The Saudi monarchy and their associates from UAE, along with some fanatic Jewish and Christian groups, had been working together to sponsor Wahhabism, Salafism, Tablighi and Jamaati Islami sects, which are directly contributing to the creation of the Muslim terrorist groups like Al-Qaeda, ISIS, Hizb ut-Tahrir and Jabhat al-Nusra, whom are directly destroying the backbone of real truth of Islam. In Islam there are no extremist ideologies. Islam resembles peace, which will be upheld with the arrival of Imam Mahdi, PBUH, the greatest true Messiah, and Jesus Christ, PBUH. In 1926, the British Empire patronized the current Saudi monarchy to establish the so-called Royal Kingdom of Saudi Arabia in Nahd with Abdulaziz ibn Saud, inhabitant of Nahd, whom were desert robbers but became a so-called royal king. Subsequently, they threw out Ottoman Empire from holy city Mecca and Medina and took over the two holy mosques. Since the 1920s, the legacies of Saudi monarchy have established Wahhabi and Salafi ideologies, which had been working against the true Islam. The Grand Mufti of Kingdom Saudi Arabia Abdul Rahman ibn Abdullah al-Ashshik, along with his forefather Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab al-Nahi from Nahd, Saudi Arabia, is the leader of Salafi and Wahhabi movement. These hypocrites are not just mentally blind but also physically handicapped. The current prince of Saudi monarchy, Mohammed bin Salman, is working ambitiously to bring about a modern change to Saudi Arabia under the disguise of bringing a total destruction. His ruthless plans have caused tremendous devastation in Yemen and Syria, which have led to the killing of thousands of innocent Yemenis and Syrians, also displaced millions as agent of Israel and patroned by US President Donald Trump. This Millennium Prophecy Statement will act as his final warning to bring about a change to his immoral actions in Yemen, Syria, and Saudi Arabia. It is confirmed that Saudi royal King Salman bin Abdulaziz, along with his son Mohammed bin Salman, are not at all Muslim, nor do they represent any faction of Islam. It is also confirmed that Mohammed bin Salman is directly working for the interest of Benjamin Netanyahu of Israel and Donald Trump of USA. The young generations of Arabian Peninsula already have awakened up to the immoral of actions of Saudi monarchy. It's only a matter of days to bring about a complete annihilation of Saudi monarchy, along with their accomplices. UAE, Egypt, Kuwait, Qatar, Oman and Bahrain will also face the same fate of punishment by the arrival of Imam Mahdi, PBUH, which is validated by the Young Arab Spring Movement. His Eminency Dr. Hazrat Sheikh Shah Sufi Emin Alam is inviting the President of Turkey and OIC, Organization of Islamic Cooperation, Recep Tayyip Erdogan, and the Prime Minister of Malaysia Dr. Mohamed Mahathir to prepare for the work of Imam Mahdi's World Peace Mission. The current world situation is a direct threat to Islam and true identity of Prophet Muhammad SM as well as his legacy. Therefore, it is your utmost duty to work together to uphold the dignity of Prophet Muhammad SM to pave the way for the arrival of Imam Mahdi, PBUH, and Jesus Christ, PBUH, for the establishment of ultimate peace. The Organization of Islamic Cooperation, OIC, will play an effective role to be organizing the Muslim army to work and support for the world peace mission of Imam Mahdi, PBUH, and international security to eliminate all the superpowers along with their superiority and attitude. In 1917, after the First World War, the United Kingdom has declared the support for independent Jewish state in Palestine with the Balfour Declaration. Again in May 14, 1948, the UK contributed with other superpowers to establish the State of Israel on the land of Palestine. The United Kingdom's involvement in the establishment of Saudi Arabia and Israel led to their complete destruction as a kingdom around the world. Since 1945, the United Nations has been completely paralyzed and does not play any effective role for the international peace and security. This World Federation, UN, is only working for the interest of Israel and USA along with other superpowers. All of these conspiracies must be paid with severe punishment by the regime of Imam Mahdi. Millions of Muslims are suffering in India by the oppressive ruler of Narendra Modi. These oppressed rulers have no care for United Nations charters or resolutions. There are billions of sufferers around the globe, especially Palestinians, Syrians, Yemenis, Kashmiris of India, Rohingyas of Myanmar and Uyghurs of China. All the sufferers around the globe will be free of oppressed and tyrant rulers, also will have the ultimate safety and security by the Imam Mahdi's World Peace Mission. Signed and sealed by His Eminency Dr. Hazrat Sheikh Shah Sufi Muhammad Nurul Alam. 43rd, direct descendant from the Prophet of Islam, Hazrat Muhammad SM, PBUH. President, World Spiritual Assembly New York, USA. Chief of the Mission, World Human Rights Service Council, New York, USA. UN Permanent Representative for the Civil Society to the UNHQ New York, Geneva, Vienna, and Addis Ababa, Ethiopia, since 1985, and other UN specialized agencies around the world. Reference 1. ISBN -978057862640-6. His Eminency Dr. Hazrat Sheikh Shah Sufi Emin Alam's Millennium Prophecy Statement, Authentic History of the World Arrival of Imam Mahdi, PBUH, with Reemergence of Jesus Christ, A, to Co-create Heaven on Earth. 2. ISBN hash 978-0615361284, World Heritage and Records of Sufism. 3. Modern prophet means those who research the authentic prophecies in accordance of Holy Quran, Bible Christian, Torah Judaism, Kalkapuran, Hinduism, as well as sacred holy books of Hinduism, Buddhism, and Zionism.